Hello guys, and welcome to this new thingy I'm gonna be doing over the next 5 weeks. It's basically just gonna be predictions every week. They're gonna come out, I guess, each Monday. Let's get to it. Before we start though, I do want to announce the winners of my Obey Fanta skin giveaway. Coma B2 and Deceptifan 1993. You guys have won, and I will message you both a Obey Fanatos code. I think it's for the PC. I'm not sure if you can use it on Xbox as well. You can figure that out. I'm not too sure yet. Anyway, let's get back to the video. Thank you for everyone who participated in the giveaway. There will be more in the future, so just look out for it. They might be hidden a bit in the videos here and there. First game is gonna be Dick Nashas versus Elevate. Dick, obviously, being a really, really strong team, I think this is gonna go 2-0 for Dick. I don't really see Elevate picking a game off here, especially after Fails left. I think Fails was not necessarily the best player on that team, but he's a really, really talented player. And I thought he might have been kind of the guy that held the team together, so they didn't troll as much. I think if they stayed together, they could have been one of the strongest teams. Definitely like a top 4 contender. I think Dick is going to take this though. They're not going to lose 2-0. It's going to be a split, or it's going to be Dick that has 2-0-ing Elevate. Dick are playing really well right now. I know that from scrims. I just think that Dick is going to get this 2-0. I don't see them really losing to Elevate, especially not in the first one. They don't offer anything. Next one's gonna be Annex versus Pappies. This is a bit of a rough one, right? Because Pappies are definitely the underdogs. I think this season or this split, we're gonna see a really big gap in skill between the lowest three or four teams in the SPL and the highest 4 and 5 teams. And I think the big question here is whether Yannix is gonna manage to be a top 4 contender, or if they're gonna kinda flop. I think they'll show up. Honestly, they always show up. I think the addition of Fails was really strong. Doggy as well is a really good player. If Seiya did not like wanna win anymore, I get why they did that. I think their biggest weakness right now is they fuck around a bit too much. They have to get serious mode on, try some new stuff. I think Pappies, on the other hand, is like the underdog, and I think if they get one win, they're gonna 2-0. So if Pappy goes 1-0, which is a Pappy 2-0, I do think Yannix is gonna 2-0 this. The thing is, like, I don't see Pappies coming back from losing a game 1. And I don't see Yannix coming back from losing a game 1. I think it's just gonna be too big of a blow to either team. So I think it's more safe to say that's gonna be Annex 2-0. It could be a Pappies 2-0 as well. I don't see the splitting though. I honestly think that momentum just means so much in this matchup. I know Pappy is a team kind of emotion. They are able to turn sometimes, so is Annex obviously, but yeah. I also wanna mention that EU is gonna be my most knowledgeable throughout this whole series, so might get a lot of the NAs wrong. I do want to take my guess, and as this season progresses, I will kind of learn the NA games. I can have a better say, because I will of course be watching those games, but I don't really play NA ranked. I didn't really watch too much of the last season. I watched some of the key games of the opponents who went to Masters, but didn't really watch any of the lower teams too much. Saw Gaming of Flashpoint, so I honestly think that Saw is gonna win this, playing under a new name now. I think I see Saw winning this. FP, of course. Pretty good team. I don't know, they have been kinda struggling a lot lately. In the last season as well. They're kind of the upset team though, right? Like they kinda get on a streak. I do see Saw touring this. I think in the first week we are mainly gonna see a lot of 2-0s. So yeah, that's gonna be the first of the NA games. I just wanna check something real fast here. Yeah, of course, being the shadow Q team and the Benji team as well, right? Yeah, and Dante Lefago. Did he have another in-game? He might have. Never really. Now he's a new addition, I guess. Just like the eager player, the jungler, he's gonna be interesting. Next game is gonna be Allegiance versus Luminosity. I think the addition of Nero Ma is good. It's good for Allegiance. I think PBM was a really strong player and I never really got why he benched himself. I think he's better than Vivian. I don't see Allegiance taking that. That was obviously a misclick. I think Luminosity has done a really, really strong team. The question is if Luminosity kind of set a foot off the gas pedal, or if they didn't, if they're just gonna keep it on. I think they want to prove a lot after Masters, and therefore I'm gonna say that this is gonna be 2-0 for LG. Because what we could have seen if they won Masters or something like that, they might have taken the foot a bit off the gas, and therefore we could have like seen a split or an Allegiance 2-0. I do think Luminosity are gonna take this though. Dick versus OG, I'm gonna be very fast with this. I think Dick is gonna 2-0. I think OG by far might be the weakest team in the SPL right now, depending on how the puppies and the elevates play. There's some good players on that team, they're not bad at all. I think where they struggle is they don't have a lot of synergy. Like, they have players who tilt, they have players who get really nervous, especially against one of the bigger orcs and the bigger team, Stigmatize, who's gonna have no problem at all. I think the one thing I could see is a split where Dignitas gets too confident and too cocky and does something completely stupid, like try out some strat in this PL, which you can do, but you really like shouldn't fuck too much around, especially this early on. So I think it's gonna be 2-0 for Dick. Then we're gonna have Energy and the Rival, of course. And this is a really interesting one, because Rival and Energy, obviously being like two of the best teams in the EU, I think Rival, Energy, us, and Dick are gonna be top contenders. I think Energy are picking up more and more and more. I think Energy is a really, really strong team. I think Rival is a really strong team as well. I see the split thing. I think it's more likely gonna be an Energy 2-0. We know that Rival has been struggling and always will be struggling in the online phases of SPL. I think that's gonna be it as well. I think this is gonna be a split though. I see maybe Rival taking game one and then Energy going like, oh okay, well we know your strat, Rival kind of not being a one sorry, I'm still a bit sick. Rival not being a one trick pony at all. But I think they're gonna have one strat or something that's gonna be super strong. We haven't scrimmed them at all, so I don't know. But Energy just playing so consistently well, and I think they kind of figured out this meta a lot better than they did in the start of the last one, where they're playing like Merc jungle and stuff. Elevate versus Puppies. This is a pretty rough one, because this is, again, I think whoever takes game one is gonna take game two, kind of, but I think the main thing here is that it's gonna be rough, man. I might even go for a split. I just said that it's gonna be whoever takes game one is gonna take game two. It's so rough at Elevate now, right? Because, like, they are gonna be having a rough time without fails. Of course, what the f... Who is this? Of course, let me see real fast, mister. Sorry, Mr. Nika could be a good addition in the jungle. I might even say Puppies is gonna 2-0 this. I think No Nomus is a super good solo lane. I think they have a super strong duo lane as well. Like, that is the main, very scary. It's if Puppy win the first, they're gonna 2-0, but if Elevate win the first, it's gonna be a 1-1. I'm gonna go for the 1-1. Bay versus Yannix. I'm gonna be biased as fuck, of course, and say that we're gonna 2-0 this. That's just how I'm gonna go throughout the whole thing, pretty much. I could see us maybe lose a game to something spicy. If we get 2-0, I think that's it. It's fair to say that that's gonna be upset. Definitely go and check out some other videos though if you wanna more colored opinion, but I do think it's fair to say that we'll win this. The only real downside you have here is Twig is on vacation right now, so he's actually only coming back Thursday. So you could go for a split if you think that's gonna affect it at all. I think we're gonna 2-0 though. LG against Noble. I think it's gonna be a safe 2-0 for Luminosity. I don't think Noble have been playing too much up to the top teams at all, and I don't think they'll do it, sadly. I think they're kinda the team that's a bit unlikely to upset. Of course, I don't know any history pretty much in NA. I just watch some of the top games before we go to LAN. This bit I will follow a lot though, because if I don't have the time. No babies. Shout out to Milk Stealth. Next game here is going to be United versus Memory of A. And this is rough, right? Because United, you just added the new support player, they added Polar Bear Mike. I think Mike, as I said before, is a super strong player, and honestly, like, Memory of Gabe, I guess it's like Snoopy, Yannick, there are a strong roster as well, with Heron and Sinusaur as well, of course. This is gonna be a rough one, honestly. I think maybe United are gonna choke and get 2-0'd. They're definitely, I think that they are gonna be the strongest team the longer the season go. I just think Memory of Gabe have better team synergy. Snoopy, of course, playing together with Yonic. Can her win forever? why does it say Walrus left? Walrus is still in Memory of Gabe, right? Allegiance against Flashpoint. Again, it's gonna be rough. I'm gonna give it to Allegiance though. I think they will 2-0. I don't see Flashpoint winning too much this split, honestly, after the rough performance last split as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and say that Allegiance is gonna 2-0 this. And then we have Ego vs Saw. This is super interesting, actually. I think that we might see an Ego 2-0. I think the new jungler is gonna impress everyone a lot. I think Saw is a super strong team as well. But I'm not sure. Again, I don't know too much about NA at all, and I will get more knowledge, and I might be horribly wrong. Saw is a super strong team as well. I don't know, I might go for a split here, honestly. I think it's more likely that it's gonna be a 2-0 in either direction, but it's so rough for me to say, so I'm just gonna go for the split, the lucky split. Hope I get it. But that's gonna be it for the week 1 predictions. I hope you guys like this kind of content. I do want to point out that the Ganesha video should be out really, really soon, but I'm just, as you guys can hear, still a bit sick, getting over my illness. I've been ill for like a week now. Been sick for so long, so annoying. But yeah, also the overview series is gonna finish off soon. The O10 dream finished off, means we're gonna go back to Rank in Hindsight Edition. I might start streaming a lot, starting in like 1.5 week. I think I'm gonna get on a stream schedule. Basically, I just have to finish school next Friday. I'm pretty much Gucci, so I'll start streaming a lot then. Yeah, and then we can upload some games from the stream, obviously, to the channel. I'm thinking just whenever I'm not feeling like making any other content, but I will try and keep up the consistent once a day upload. I think it's very, very, very good for the channel. But again, congrats to Comer B and the Mister. Or the Siptifan 1993, I just had to remember the name of that. Again, thank you so much for watching. Leave a like, leave a comment, and as always, make sure to subscribe as well. And new thing, you can press that bell to the notification thing. That's gonna be nice. But thank you so much for watching. Peace out. I like the way you press them buttons, boy.